Hi folks, Nina Oliveri here. Today we're at the Bedford Free Public Library and we're going to go in and talk to Noreen O'Gara. She is the assistant director and she's going to share with us some of the wonderful things that go on here at the library. So why don't you folks come on in and hear all the exciting things. Hi Noreen.
Hey Nina, good to see you.
Nice to see you too. Thank you so much for allowing me and my friends here to come on in and share with us a little bit about the library.
So you noticed when you came in that we have book bags waiting for people to pick up outside.
Yeah.
We also have bags of food. We work with the social workers in town, so if somebody needs some food, something to help them through the week, or they need to learn how to get onto the SNAP program, those bags are also outside waiting for them. They can just sign their name and take
nice.
One of the bags. And then we have a bunch of book sale things from our friends, since our friends do so much to support us, so there's always good stuff to get out there, so pretty cheap. So that's what you see when you first come into the building.
And then there's a lot, actually, just share with us the different programs that you have available and a lot of, you know, just resources that are here for the community and not just for Bedford, just for even the surrounding areas or anybody that wants to come in and, you know, just pay a visit to the Bedford Free Public Library.
Bedford Free Public Library. Yeah. So the first thing you do when you come into the building that way, you see the circulation desk, and those are the people who can help you get your library card if you have any problems with your account. They also distribute COVID tests, so you can get your COVID test if you need it, and they also help you set up your curbside appointment if that's something you need. Right as you get a little further in, we have wireless printing for anyone who doesn't have a printer at home and wants to send a print job over to the library. You can just pick it up right here downstairs by the clock over there.
It's free.
Well, that is a little different. One, we have so many printing options. The upstairs ones are free. The color one down here is a little bit 25 cents a page.
Okay,
so it has stuff. It's great if you're in a real hurry and you don't want to, when it's on your phone, you just want to send it. It's perfect. So lots of new books down here. We're in front of the new nonfiction, which is always fascinating. Lots of AV, audiobooks, music, DVDs, Blu-rays, all of that back down there. Really, and a nice table to sit and study at. The other thing that's down here is we also have a study room that you can book, and the people at the circulation desk would be more than happy to help you with that.
I've used that many a time.
It's great when you really need to be away and have a little bit of quiet. And then all the new books down here, and then the reserve shelf, so if you order books and you want to pick them up, you can just come in and grab them. We have self-checkout. You can check out yourself, or you can talk to our great staff at the circulation desk who will do anything for you. Within reason. And then we can even teach you how to use the Minuteman Library Network app, which allows you to check out books on your own phone. So that's really nice and handy. So that's
and a couple of things that have really intrigued me on this floor alone is the, we'll go to the children's room after, but the list of things.
The Library of Things. The things,
yes. So that is a very unique kind of feature that I didn't know about in the past.
Yeah.
So until you actually are the one that made me aware of it.
Right.
So
we have
some. Can you share? What is that?
The Library of Things are all sorts of objects that you can check out for a couple of weeks at a time. They include things like hotspots. They include things like laser stud finders. They include laminators. We have a doll for dementia patients if they need to be soothed, if you want to see if it's going to work for your family member who might need a little of that. Lots of little fun things for the kids, a lot of coding things, lots of sort of games for them. So there's some great things, some knitting needles, a yarn winder, all sorts of crazy things. A lot of things that you only want to use once.
Now, what about the children's library?
The children's library is the most fun place in the whole building. Absolutely. We've got terrific stuff there. We have a play wall for little ones so they can move and manipulate things. We've got a couple of wooden play things as you go into that space. The books in the smaller part for the picture book section, the shelving can be moved so we could close that room off if we needed to, if we wanted to do just a bigger story hour. We also have tons of you know, books for all ages from birth through about grades 5th, 6th. We have a turtle, Murphy, He's the most famous turtle in Bedford. People come to sing him happy birthday songs. He loves it. He will swim over to you if you sing a happy birthday song. But if he starts going like this, he wants to be fed and you need to walk away, because he will do this to everybody all the time. We have an open story time room, which is actually filled with toys now for the kids to play with. So that's lots of fun. It's a great place to explore lots of different activities. We change out what's in the story time room. We change out all the, sometimes it's the kitchen, sometimes it's motor toys, sometimes it's train tracks. So lots of different things change about once a week. So it's fun.
Now, you also have a calendar of events.
We do. We have a calendar of events. We have a newsletter you can sign up for on the front page of our website, and then you get that in the beginning of the month with all our events. The calendar lives on the front page of the website. And so, you know, there's lots of things to find out about what we're doing. This afternoon we're having Legos, big Lego party going on in there. We're having Sarah Gardner, the musician, come on a Saturday outside, and she'll bring music to all the kids outside. It's a lot of fun things going on.
And summer reading. Some programs for adults too.
We do. This year we have summer reading for everybody, for middle school students. And Pam has this kind of game upstairs by her station for the middle school students. Little guys can run sign up here in the room for the children, and then I do something for adults too. So if you want to sign up and join my summer reading program, you might win an ice cream card once a week, and you might win something bigger, and then at the end of the year you will win something definitely bigger. We do have some stuff going on for adults. We have a genealogy club that meets pretty regularly, so if you are a fanatic about genealogy and you want to learn more, that's once a month. We have a series of lectures by Dr. Breen from Brandeis, and that's always packed. We get great things. A little quiet in the summer right now because the grown-ups kind of hang out, but in the winter we have a series of different events, and if you have a suggestion about programming, just can let me know because we'll think about it.
Okay. And
we're very receptive. Whatever the community wants, we try to do.
And what is the sacred thing that lives upstairs?
Oh, my goodness. So we have a national treasure. We have the Bedford flag, which is from the 18th century, belonged to the Page family who lived here in Bedford. The flag was given to the Pages by the King, by King George, in 1737, because he was supposed to be protecting the King, as you know, against the French, the Indian, with whomever they were fighting at that point. But within two generations, they were using the flag to rally the Minutemen against the King. So we do know the flag was carried at the North Bridge during those first early battles. And it was written about the family. The Pages preserved all their family history. So when we received the flag from the Page family, we had a really good oral history as well as some written materials about the flag. Okay. And the flag balcony has tells you about the history of the flag, of how it was conserved and preserved, has a line, what is that, thread by thread reproduction of the flag, but the flag itself is closed in low light, low humidity room. People come from all over. We have a guest book, and we've had people come from literally all over to see the flag if you're a vexillologist.
Yeah. Very nice.
One of the things you'll see on the way up there is the scanner, which is by the reference desk. People love the scanner. It just is like you can get all your documents saved, and it's just a wonderful thing. A couple of study rooms down, glass study rooms in the opposite the periodical section, so that's nice. And then opposite that is the teen room. And we have a really expansive teen room, one of the best in the Minuteman Network, I think, because we have so much space and the chairs can move around because, you know, sometimes teens are not talking to that person they talked to yesterday. They want to move around, sit with somebody else. That's, you know how it is.
Yes.
Exactly. So a lot of nice space up there. And then on the level above us is kind of the quiet space where people are pretty serious about what they're doing, and we try to keep the noise down. Mm-hmm. And then above that, you can go visit our beehive.
Yes. So that's something I haven't visited in a while.
Yeah, so it's beautiful now because they're out and they're swarming around. You're like, oh my God, it's going to be great. We're going to have honey. So, yeah.
So the other thing that I discovered years ago when I had kids mm-hmm. was that a lot of libraries, especially here in Bedford, is that there's passes to different museums.
Yes.
So if you want to talk a little bit about that?
So the Museum Pass program is really good. It gives you, used to be free passes, but most of the museums now charge something, so it's discounted.
It's significantly
yeah,
discounted.
It's
though,
a, so a big know. Help, especially if you've got a lot of kids with you and you want to do something that's a little bit more, you know, a big family event. So that's available. You can check online and then you can pick it up here. But some of the museums have even moved to, you just need to check it out online and just get a code and you can go right into the museum with that code. So it's very simple. You don't even have to come to visit us. But we want you to come and visit us anyway because we want to talk to you and say hello. But it is super easy now. So a lot of great things with that.
Well, there's definitely a lot to love about the library.
Yeah.
And Bedford does a great job with their library. And I mean, I know that I feel blessed to be part of this community. And one of the reasons is because the library that we have here. So thank you.
Oh, thank you. It's great to come visit us anytime.